What is up, guys? In today's video, I'm going to be going over the best loadout in Fortnite Chapter 4. We just got a new balance update yesterday, completely reworking all of the weapons or most of the weapons in Chapter 4. So I'm going to be going over the changes, what I think of the best setup in Chapter 4 right now. If you guys do enjoy this video, find it helpful or informative, remember to give it a like, subscribe if you'd like to see more, and comment down below what your favorite thing to run has been so far in Chapter 4. So yesterday we got a huge amount of changes to the game. Both shotguns got buffed. The tactical pistol got buffed, the hammer got nerfed, the Excalibur rifle got nerfed, and that's basically it as far as weapon changes, and that affects a lot of the top tier items in the game right now, I think. And so far in Chapter 4, I don't think there has just been one set thing that you have to run. In past seasons of Fortnite, there kind of was a lot of like AUG auto shotty last chapter was just kind of the move in zero build, but I feel like you actually have a lot of choices for what you want to run this season. I'm going to be going over two main setups, but there are some like differences you can make between them. As far as shotguns go, even with the Maven auto shotgun buff, something about that gun just doesn't feel right to me. It just doesn't feel as good as the auto shotgun felt last season. And the Thunder shotgun is insane, and the spray weapons are pretty insane this season. So I think the Thunder shotgun is going to be the way to go. The Mythic Prime last season would deal 195 max on the fully loaded shot. The Gold Thunder Shotgun does 195 max on every shot. You don't need to fully load it or anything. So the Thunder Shotgun, as far as damage is concerned, is basically a fully loaded Mythic Prime at all times if you have the gold one. Obviously, the rarities do, like, the damage goes down as the rarity goes down. But either way, you basically get the fully loaded shot of the Prime every shot out of your Thunder Shotgun. It's really good. Even the white one can hit for 170 max. So for that reason, that and the fact that, like I said, I don't think the Maven shotgun feels right for whatever reason, I prefer the Thunder Shotgun. And the spray weapons are also really good. Both the Twin Mag SMG and the Tactical Pistol are great weapons to use. And even the Machine Pistol, while I do think it's the weakest of the spray weapons, it is quite good. So the first loadout is going to be a very just like standard basic all-around type loadout. You're going to be covered at every range here, and we are going to have mobility. So we're going to go Thunder Shotgun, your choice of the Twin Mag SMG or the Tactical Pistol, just depending on which you prefer. I think they're both good. If they're playing build mode, I would prefer the Twin Mag SMG because it's better at like frying walls and taking walls and getting damage through walls, you know. For zero build, I think I'd prefer the Tactical Pistol. If your aim isn't the best, you're probably better off with the SMG, but the Tactical Pistol has high damage and a two headshot multiplier, meaning it benefits a lot from headshots. I think regardless of rarity, with the Tactical Pistol, you're going to be doing around 50 damage or so with the headshots, so you can melt people very quickly with this pistol. The fire rate isn't as insane with as the SMG is, though, so if you're not as confident with your aim, maybe you'd rather have the Twin Mag SMG. Then we're going to go heals, and then the Shockwave Hammer for mobility, and then we're going to go the Red Eye Assault Rifle. I think as far as like long-range weapons go right now, you have the Red Eye Assault Rifle and you have the DMR back, but the Red Eye Assault Rifle has a higher fire rate, less recoil, it's hit scan, meaning the bullets immediately teleport to the target. It has a higher magazine size. The Red Eye Assault Rifle is just more convenient to use and easier to use, and I feel like it's more reliable for that reason. The DMR can be good if you only hit headshots all the time, it'll kill very quickly, but if you ever miss shots because of the travel time or just the weirdness of it, it's not as good. So I think the Red Eye Assault Rifle is a better choice for most people. It's more convenient to use, and it's going to be more reliable for that reason. And since it is easier to use, I feel like it's going to be better at fighting against good players. So the first setup is going to be Thunder Shotgun, your choice of spray weapon between the Twin Mag SMG and the Tactical Pistol, heals, Shockwave Hammer, and then the Red Eye Assault Rifle. Those are going to be the five items. There's one change you could make to this if you really want to. I haven't been able to play an insane amount with this to really know for sure, but prior to the nerf to the Excalibur, the shotgun plus Excalibur was a pretty insane combo, and you would basically just alternate between them like double pump. You would shoot your shotgun, swap to the Excalibur, shoot that, swap to the shotgun, and you would just alternate back and forth. And since the Excalibur had really good hip fire accuracy and really high damage, you could kill people in like two shots, essentially. Like shoot your shotgun once, the Excalibur once, and then that second shotgun shot would pretty much always kill them if they didn't die from the Excalibur already. But with the nerf, they hit the hipfire accuracy of the Excalibur, they hit the damage of the Excalibur, and they hit the explosive damage of it. So I don't know if this is as good. It still probably is good, but it's just not as insane. So that is another thing you could do if you really like that playstyle, and it is fun to do. Thunder Shotgun, Excalibur, Heals, Hammer, and Red Eye. It's basically the same thing, but you drop the spray weapon for the Excalibur. The ceiling on this probably isn't as good as it used to be, but it is still quite good. So that is the first setup. Very basic, very like traditional Fortnite setup of AR, shotgun, SMG, heals, mobility. The next setup is going to be if you want to take advantage of one of the power weapons like the RPG or the bow, or maybe even the Excalibur if you wanted to use it more as just like a ranged option. And for this, you basically need your spray weapon and your mid-range weapon, mid to long-range weapon, to be the same item. And I think the two best choices for that are either the normal assault rifle or the SCAR, or the tactical pistol once again, because with the recent update, it got reduced recoil and reduced bloom, making it more accurate. So the tactical pistol is very good up close, and it's also very good at medium to long range. You would be surprised at how insane this weapon is, like past like what you would consider pistol range. It is very, very good. So for this setup, you would use something like Thunder Shotgun, the SCAR, the tactical pistol, RPG, Hammer, and then heals. And this setup is insane because the RPG is ridiculous. The hammer and the RPG combine very well. It's basically like Shockwave Goo Gun was last season, or Shockwave Boogie Bomb was the season before that. You basically just hit yourself up with the hammer, and this gives you a really easy time getting RPG splash damage on somebody. And what makes this even more ridiculous than what the Shockwave Goo Gun was or Shockwave Boogie Bomb was is that your hammer recharges. So even if you go for this and you don't really hit a good shot off of it, or maybe you aren't happy with the angle you have and you end up not doing it, it's not as big of a deal as if you wasted shockwaves, because the hammer recharges over time, and you don't have to think about it as much. You can use it as often as you would like and the hammer will recharge. They did make the hammer recharge a little bit slower, but it's still not really a problem. So I think RPG and Shockwave Hammer is going to be a problem this season if they don't do something about the RPG spawn rate. I think this is going to be the broken combo in Zero Build. Pretty much every fight is just going to be decided by Shockwave Hammer. You get like 100 plus damage on them with the rocket, and then you shotgun them for hopefully 100 plus, and the fight's over at that point. But the main weakness of this setup would just be that really long range fights, you're definitely going to lose out to the Red Eye Assault Rifle using either the SCAR or the Tactical Pistol. Both of them are bloom-based weapons, so they're not as reliable at those long-range fights. But it's really easy to make your long-range fights close-range fights this season. If you get a decent amount of tags on the person, you don't have to like full take the long-range fight, but it's very easy to close the gap with the Shockwave Hammer because it is rechargeable and you don't have to worry about like wasting it or anything. With Shockwaves, there would be times where like you could push somebody, but would it be worth using your last Shockwave, you know? You don't really have to consider that with the hammer since it recharges. So I feel like it's very easy to close the gap on people this season. And if you are coming in on your hammer and you have the RPG, you open the fight with the RPG, and pretty much any fight you open with an RPG on somebody, you're gonna win that fight. The RPG does way too much damage, and the shotgun, the Thunder Shotgun, does a lot of damage right now as well. So those combo extremely well. And I think that is going to be the like cheesy broken combo this season. It's just going to be hammer and RPG. So those are the two setups that I would recommend for Chapter 4. Like I said, the first one is very traditional. It's Thunder Shotgun, your choice of spray weapon, heals, the hammer, and then the Red Eye Assault Rifle. And then the second one, if you want to take advantage of one of the power weapons like the RPG or the bow, you use Thunder Shotgun, Tactical Pistol, or the normal Assault Rifle or the SCAR. Heals, hammer, and then your choice of power weapon like the RPG, the bow, whatever you like. But that is gonna be it for today's video. I hope you guys found this helpful and informative. If you did, please do remember to give it a like, subscribe if you want to see more, comment down below what your favorite thing to use has been so far in Chapter 4, and I will see you guys in the next video. Thanks for watching.